Ça vient. Allez, je peux
le faire tout de suite, monsieur.
Hi everybody. Here we are at the Pigonnet. You'll hear voices, gay voices of people having their aperitif and getting ready for their dinner. And we're in this beautiful 200-year-old garden where Cezanne painted. And they have delighted me with a wonderful glass of champagne to start my painting session as just a generous gift. I love coming here, and last night when I came here for our 36th wedding and had such a nice time, and they allowed me to come here and paint in the garden whenever I want. So today, if you cannot hear, let us know. We're really trying different things, and we hope that we have this sound thing better with a different mic today. So if you cannot hear, please let us know. You can give us negative feedback just so that we can try to get better. Haley is with me and she will field your questions. Since I did the webinar on Sunday and it was announced that I would be happy to answer some questions, I'm going to do my painting session, and then as you have questions, I'm happy to answer and do a little bit more talking today if the equipment is working, if the mic is working, the new mic. Just let us know and ask the questions you want. I mean, it's more, rather than making a masterpiece for the Louvre, it's more about learning, about the creative process, about the delight of this garden, sharing. And just every time I come to this garden, my soul feels comforted and warmed being here. I look forward to it. You know how you look forward to something with your husband? This is the place I look forward to coming. It's just everything comes together. We came here for New Year's Eve and danced all night here. Just the two of us, tête-à-tête. It was fabulous. So here I am back, and I'll just start my painting. But as you have questions, you can interrupt or save your questions for the end if you want. I'm just, today, I'll let the painting run, but I'm okay about stopping and answering questions. And maybe I better take another sip so that I can really perform well. I do always start my painting session by saying, "And the glory of the Lord is thy reward." Not anything else. The glory of the Lord is thy reward. Remember, Jill, that's what you're after. Nothing else.
National Compte des Pays, je vous paye.
Je peux les aider en échange.
Vous me dites, non?
Et après, peut-être, on est gentil, on peut faire un groupe de vie, ou de demi, si tu
as une de vie.
Oui, c'est bien.
Comme on n'avait pas de crédit encore, on a demandé aux arôles. Il a appris quelque chose, on a un facteur. C'est très franchement.
So we have Marcia Griffin Manuel, Dale Pierce Taylor. Marcia says hi again. Diane Irvin, Eleanor Smith Cox, Leslie Carton, Tracy, yep, from LA, Tracy Belton, Christian Stemkowski, Martha Lee Thwaite. Sarah Edwards, Nick Cruz Velleman, Lisa Robbins, Caroline Holmes Nichols, Cindy Irvin Ivalatis, Nick Cruz Velleman says genial, Eve Skakowski, Celie Gehrig, salut, Lisa Robbins. Wow, we've got quite a great group tonight. Harrison's there. Susan Yancey Elder. Robert Sadler says, love your mantra, Jill. That begins your paintings. Ben Preston. Mary Pat King. One of the most faithful. Elizabeth Babs Duquesne. Beverly Heffernan. Sandy Campbell. And the list goes on. Holt Cleaver, Diana Ciorba. Cindy Irvin, Ivalata says, my daughter Maggie and I are watching in Macon, Georgia.
She's one that we went to high school
with. Oh, wow.
And I have to be on the Nick watching.
Oh.
Don't tell on me.
Sabu David, or David. Claudia Wisdom Good. Nick Cruz Velleman said, stop, you're doing great, Jill.
I almost gave up when I knew he was watching.
I love seeing the attack of your strokes, is what he says. Thank you. So Brenda Arndt says, first time watching, thanks for sharing, from Dallas, Anthology of Plano. Nancy Norris. Yeah. Anna McClure. Lynn McMillan. So Anna Kozak McClure asks, sounds busy. Do you have a live audience too?
No.
You did a few seconds ago, and all the guys sitting at that table were watching.
Well, they had no idea that they were going to be. They came for the vodka.
So we have a question from Robert Sadler, so it's actually Trisha. What color is Jill using for her dark greens?
I'm using ultramarine mixed with raw sienna for the distant greens that are muted greens, and these foreground greens are Prussian blue and cadmium yellow deep that bring very warm green that comes forward.
Could you hear that? Robert and Trisha?
Could you hear that it was ultramarine, blue, and raw sienna for the distant greens? And Prussian blue and cadmium yellow deep for the very warm greens.
So it seems that they can hear well when you get closer to the camera like that, yeah. So Nancy Hill says, stayed there at Le Pigonnet on a talk tour and got to tour your personal studio. So beautiful. Kathy K. Wilson from Louisiana. Denise Fenelon, watching from Tucson. Jane Moody Bergman says, hey, Jill, watching from Beach on Gulf Coast.
Another cousin.
family trip. Now, we have a question from Martha Leithwaite, who's wondering how you choose where you begin your painting.
Very good question. It can never be a formula. Since I said, if you have a formula, your art is dead. So each time it should be a new place. And Leo Marchutz, my mentor, I went to the Marchutz School of Painting and Drawing, said one must start from the inside out. Well, what does that mean? From the inside of the painting out, meaning the fountain that's drawing my eye, or everything that's giving birth to the fountain. Right now I'm working on everything that's giving birth to the fountain, but it's also the inside out of me. I love that phrase, start from the inside out, because it can mean so many things. It's a very abstract phrase, and it gives you license, gives you freedom to start somewhere, but start from the inside out. Start also from the inside out of your soul, outward. Take in nature, take it in through the senses, ask yourself, what are my sensations? Contemplate in silence. I got here 45 minutes ago, and I've been walking around and contemplating the garden and doing a drawing. I've already done a couple of drawings and a quick painting sketch, mise en page, and then and listening, hearing, tasting, smelling, and hopefully the final result will be moitié humain, moitié divine, half human, half divine. I receive, and it wakes up my inner poetry, and it goes out on the canvas like a breath. So to start, it's always from the inside out.
So Jill, you tell me if you want me to keep telling you. There are a lot of people joining today. So I don't want to distract you.
Je me rappelle. Après, vous me dites, Roselyne, ce que c'est.
Oui, j'ai compris.
Juste à me.
We have someone asking what your medium is.
My medium is poppy seed oil and bi-rectified turpentine. That's very pure turpentine. It's a little bit more turpentine than poppy seed oil. So 60% turpentine and 40% poppy seed oil that I mix up myself in a shake it up. I mix it up myself. And then I can pour it into my jar as I need it. It's my vinaigrette.
So Nick has a technical question for you. He says that he's fascinated by your medium and is wondering how long it takes you to find that ideal ratio combo of poppy seed oil and turpentine.
It's a little loose. When I go mixing, about this much poppy seed oil, and then I pour on top about this much. So 1/3 poppy seed oil and 2/3 turpentine, or 40-60%. So there's a little play in there. Like I sometimes have a line across here, fill it up with poppy seed oil, and then this, and then this is a nice pouring beak, so it pours nicely into. Sometimes I have a smaller Godet cup clipped onto my palette, and then I pour it in. But I learned this from Sam Bjorklund, my mentor at the Marschutz School 40 years ago, and I have never veered away. I love the poppy seed oil turpentine mixture because poppy seed oil is the slowest drying of all the oils. So you have walnut oil, a lot of people use linseed oil, which is the least expensive, but it's much more yellowy and it dries faster. And I'm a wet on wet. I cannot stand to paint on dried up hills of paint. I like to finish and get the painting in one go. So wet on wet is this keeps the paint the wettest the longest, and it's much more transparent, less yellow than the linseed oil. So I have used this mixture. I've been very fidel and loyal.
Le ciel est trop blanc aussi.
So Nick says, super interesting, merci.
Coming together, and now I find that I have worked with the masses of color, and I've put together the essence of what's there, and now it's me as an artist to decide how far I would like to go. I think now, for me, I would like to put in a few more accents that draw in, that bring the drawing back, the original drawing back. But one of the really nice things that can really, really help me is to have one more sip of my champagne. Just thought for those newcomers that you didn't know that I've already been served a glass of champagne on the house.
The true secret comes out.
Voila, here we go.
Silky Heart is watching, and Tammy, Arlen. So Louise Tanasa says, so I'm not the only one that drinks wine while painting.
No, this is even better than champagne. They're nice to me. Thank you. Okay, I think I should stop before I overwork. So it's just the essence of the garden. I don't know if you can hear the fountain back there, but I can hear the fountain, and the breeze has been blowing all along. It's just come into my soul and hit the chords on the inside and then bounced back out onto the canvas. So again, my language is my brush strokes. The brush strokes go onto the canvas, and then it gives the essence of the garden. If you want the exact likeness, then you come and take a picture. I'm really not interested in doing what the machine can do. We'll let the wonderful photographer do his art, and I will do my art with my language being the brush strokes. Maybe my words are not as good as my brush strokes, but I'm happy to hear some of your answer some of your questions in the best way that I know how, if you have any. And we usually post the painting the next day, and so a lot of times when I'm in the process of signing the painting the next morning, then out of memory, I would say the painting is 95% done, or 100% done and missing the signature. It just, after a night's sleep and I wake up in the morning and the new day and look at it as if it's someone else who did it, then I can see what needs to be changed or added, taken away. Van Gogh said a wonderful thing that I read before, but recently it really resonated with me. He said, if you just want to change something, usually the best way to start is just to lift it with your palette knife. Lift a big glob of paint and see what you got there in the beginning. So, here. I'm not sure what to lift because I haven't been. Voila. Thank you for joining me today. Does anyone hear me? No? Oh, thank you so much for just being with me in the moment. And it's kind of a meditative time. And I appreciate feeling your spirit. It's amazing how you feel your spirit all the way up here in the south of France. All right, well, I'm going to go have dinner with my husband. Bon appétit to me. Bye.